This video provides an overview of RefSeqGene, the standard for reporting gene-specific sequence variation. I'll review RefSeqGene's homepage, show how to find a RefSeqGene sequence for a specific gene, and then show how to display a variation in multiple RefSeq coordinate systems. I'll start on the RefSeqGene homepage. The links in the leftmost column provide several ways to access RefSeqGene sequences, including a browsable list, the nucleotide database, and FTP downloads. In the center are tools to analyze RefSeq genes, including BLAST and the Variation Reporter. And in the rightmost column, you'll find links to both NCBI and external databases, including GENE, the NIH Genetic Testing Registry, and Variation Databases. You see the standard NCBI query bar at the top of the page. This is provided for navigation to other resources at NCBI, not to search RefSeqGene. Instead, use the link Browse Genes with RefSeqGene Sequences, or link to the RefSeqGene records in the Nucleotide Database. Let's start our first task, finding a RefSeqGene sequence, by using the Browse tool. You can enter any part of a word in the Filter the Table box. For example, I'll type HFE and click Submit. In the row for the hemochromatosis gene, we see links to GENE, sequence records, GTR, and OMIM. Be aware that you may get more results than you expect, because the letters you enter may occur together in multiple contexts. One way to display the sequence of the HFE RefSeq gene record is to click on Graphics in the Views column. This opens the nucleotide records graphics display, which begins at the 5' end of the gene. I'll close the text display, and we now see tracks labeled SNP, LSDB, cited variants, genes, and alignments. The first three report placement of short variations, and the alignments show the locations of RefSeq cDNAs. Let's say you know the location of a variation on a RefSeq gene, and you want to determine its HGVS name on the cDNA or protein records. Right-click in the ruler area and select Set New Marker at Position. You can name the marker. I'll just enter my known location, 8671, and check Lock Marker. When you press OK, the dialog closes and you see the marker's location on the displayed features. Next, right-click on the marker and select Marker Details. This window reports the location of the marker in multiple coordinate systems: the start of the RefSeq gene, the start of the cDNA, the A nucleotide of the initiation codon on the cDNA, and the amino acid sequence. That's it for the demonstration, but I'd like to point out a few important links back on the RefSeq gene homepage. The guide page offers a few how-to methods, such as how to align your sequences to a RefSeq gene using BLAST, and slide presentations about RefSeq gene-related tools. The About page provides a history of the RefSeq gene project, and the Locus Reference Genomic page summarizes the LRG collaboration. If you have questions or want to request a RefSeq gene, our contact information is here on the RefSeq gene homepage. Your input will help us refine RefSeq gene to meet your needs.